Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad, and welcome to another video tutorial on the C programming language. Now, in the previous videos, we have learned about the computers and the C programming language. And in this video, we are going to see all the steps involved from writing a C program to generating an executable file from that C program. The first thing is, C is a general purpose programming language, and by using this C programming language, we can write the instructions or the computer programs. Now, the instructions written in any programming language in human readable format is called as the source code. And here, the instructions written in the C programming language is called as the C source code. Now, when we write a computer program, we are going to store that in the computer memory as a computer file. And the file which is containing this source code is called as the source file. And if the file is containing the source code written in the C programming language, then that file is also called as the C source file. Now, as I said before, we are going to write the instruction using the C programming language, and then we are going to save that in the computer memory. So to write the instructions or to write the code, we are going to use the text editors. You can use any text editor available, and you can write the C program and you can save that as a computer file. Now, while writing this C programming language, the C programming language, it provides a lot of built-in features to implement the common operations that we have to do in the program. For example, in the programming, someone has to frequently perform the input and output operations, or programmers have to work on the string values. So for all these common operations, the C programming language provides the built-in features. So the programmer can just use that built-in features, and then he can write the programs. And these features are provided in the form of C standard library. This C standard library contains all the built-in features that will perform the common operations that a programmer has to perform in his program. So while writing the C program, you are going to use that built-in features, and then you will write the program. And we will talk more about this when we write the program. And just now, remember that C programming language provides a lot of built-in features that we can use in our program, and we can easily write the programs. And the next thing is, as I said before, we are going to write the C program using a text editor, and then we are going to save that in the computer memory as a computer file. So the next thing is how we can differentiate a file which is containing the C programming language from any other file. For example, if we have a text file, then that text file will have .txt extension. So by looking at this .txt extension, we can say that that file is a text file. Similarly, for the music files which have the MP3 format, will have .mp3 extensions. And similarly, the PDF files have .pdf extension. So similar to all these files, the file which is containing the C source code will be saved with .c extension. So here, you can give any name to your file while saving it, but you have to make sure that it has the extension .c. For example, if I write a program using C programming language by using a text editor, and then while saving that file, I can give any name. For example, I can name it 1, but it should have the extension .c. So my file has to be saved as 1.c. This .c will indicate that it is a file containing the program written in the C programming language. And now the next thing is, once we write the C program using the C language, you know, we can't directly execute that code in a computer. That's because the computers, they can only understand the code which is written in the binary language or the machine code. And that's why we need to convert the source code that we have written in the C language to machine code. And we can do that by performing the compilation process. So we will perform the compilation process, and we will convert this code to the machine code, and that machine code generated by this compilation process is also called as the object code. This compilation process, it will take the source code written in the C programming language and then it will generate a new file containing the machine code representation of the source code. And now here, the file containing this object code is also called as the object file. And if you are performing this compilation process in the Windows environment, then this object file containing this object code will have .obj extension. And if you are performing this in the Linux or the Unix environment, then this object file containing the object code will have .o extension. Now here, during this compilation process, several programs are used. One of the program which is used in the compilation process is the preprocessor. Here, before the actual compilation process, your source code written in the C programming language will be processed. And as the name indicates, this preprocessor is a program. It takes the source code and then it will perform some operations on it. For example, it will remove the new lines and the spaces that you have in the source code, and also it will remove the comments, and also it will expand the header files. I know all of you guys can't understand this header files and comments. We will learn about that later, but just remember that this preprocessor is a program which is called during the first stage of this compilation process, and it will process the source code and then it will generate an optimized version of the source code, and then that optimized version of the source code produced by this preprocessor will be given to the compiler. And here, since we are talking about the C programming language, it is gonna be a C compiler, and this C compiler will generate the machine code from the source code given to it. So here, there are different C compilers are available, and although they perform the same thing, converting the source code written in C language to the machine code, they work a bit differently. Some of the compilers, they take the source code and then they generate the assembly code, and then that assembly code has to be converted to machine code. And some C compilers, they directly generate the machine code from the source code given to them. So here, two programs are mainly used, and the first one is the preprocessor. This preprocessor will take the source code written in the C programming language, and then it will produce the optimized form of the source code, and then that optimized source code which is produced by this preprocessor is given to this C compiler, and then the C compiler will generate the machine code which is also called as the object code. Now here, what you can do is you can divide your program in separate files. For example, let's say you are writing a project using the C programming language and your project contains more than 10,000 lines of C programming language instructions. So at that time, if you have that more than 10,000 lines of code in just one single file, then it will be difficult for you to manage your project. Instead of that, if you can divide that project into several different parts and also into several different files, then it will be easy for you to manage the code. So while writing the programs in the C programming language, you can divide your project into several different files. So for example, I can have different files here. For example, 1.c, then 2.c, and then 3.c. Now I can have any number of files which is containing the C source code. Now here, if your project contains more than one file containing your programs, then you have to individually compile each of them and generate the object code. So you have to perform the compilation process on this 1.c, and then you have to generate the object code for this 1.c, and then for this 2.c also you have to do the same thing, and for this 3.c also you have to do the same thing. So for each file which you have in your project, you have to perform the compilation process and you have to generate the object code for that respected source files. So now here, I'm gonna assume that my project that I'm building has three files containing the instructions written in the C programming language. So 1.c, 2.c and 3.c. So I have to perform this compilation process on each of them, and I have to generate the object code for each of them. So here, after the compilation process, I have the object code of these three files. So let's say 1.obj and 2.obj and 3.obj. Alright, now this object file is generated after this compilation process. Now here, during this compilation process, the compilers may detect some errors in your programs. So at that time, the compilers will generate the errors instead of creating the object file. So if your program is containing the errors, then the compilers will generate error and you have to go back to your source code and you have to solve those errors. So if your program contains errors, then this compilation process will detect that. Then you have to go back to your source code and you have to correct your error. And after correcting the errors, you have to again perform this compilation process. And at that time, if your program is not containing any error, then the object code will be generated. So once you get your programs error free, then the object files will be generated. Now the next thing is, now we have the object files which is containing the machine code for our project. Now the next thing that we have to do is we have to link all these files together and we have to generate an executable. And for that purpose, a program is used and it is called as the linker. And this linker, it will take the object files, all of them, and then it links them together and then it generates the executable file. And in the Windows environment, this executable will have the .exe extension, and similarly for the different platforms, they have the respected executable extensions. And here it takes the object files. And also I have said before, while writing the C program, you are going to use the features provided by the C language, and that features are provided in the C standard library. So this linker will link the features that you have used from the C standard library with your code, and then it will produce the executable. So if your project is containing only one file, then it will take that one file, and then if you have used any library functions in your program, then it links them together and produces the executable. And similarly, let's say your project is containing three files, and then after the compilation process, you will get the three object files, and this linker will take that three object files and also it links them together, and also it links the standard library functions that you have used, and then it produces the executable. Now we have this executable file which can be executed in a computer. Now during this linking process also, the linkers may find out that your program is containing some errors. For example, let's say you have made some mistakes while including or while using the features provided in the standard library. So at that time, the linker will generate the error saying that it can't link the files. So again, you have to go back to your source code and you have to find the error that you have made in your source code, and then you have to correct that. And after correcting that, you have to perform all these steps again. You have to compile them and then you have to link them. If there are no errors, then the linker will successfully create the executable. Now, the next thing that we have to do once we get an executable is we have to execute that program. And for that purpose, a program is used, and that is called as the loader. This loader will take your executable and it will load that to the primary memory, which is the RAM, stands for random access memory, and then the processor will execute it. And here, after executing your program may work or may produce the result successfully, or it may not work properly. For example, let's say you have written a program to calculate the area of a triangle, and in your source code, let's say you have done a mistake while writing the formula to calculate the area of the triangle. So that's why you will not get any error, because the computer doesn't know the formula to calculate the area of a triangle. You have to provide that correctly, but you have done the mistake in that. And that's why you will get to this execution stage, but your program, it will not produce the proper results. It will generate improper results. And that's why if your output after executing your program is not proper, then also you have to go back to your source code and you have to correct your program, and then you have to perform all these operations again, and then you have to execute your program. So this is the steps involved from writing a C program and then creating an executable and then executing that executable generated. Now the thing is, all these programs which are required to generate the executable from the C program source file, they come in a bundle. So you have to install a bundle which contains all these softwares, and that bundle is called as the toolset. So once you install a toolset for the C programming language, you will get all these softwares. You won't get the editor, you can write it in any text editor, but you will get all these programs, for example, to perform the compilation process and for this linking purpose, and all those softwares will be available in these toolsets. There are many toolsets available. For example, we have the GCC toolset, and we have Turbo C, and also we have the Microsoft specific Visual C++. You know, all these toolsets are available. They provide all these programs. So you just need to install the toolset and then you will get all these programs. Then you can build and execute your program. So this is it, guys. This is all about the steps involved from writing a C program to generating an executable from it and then executing that generated executable file. And if you like this video, then give a thumbs up. If you don't like it, then give a thumbs down. And also tell your opinion by writing the comments in the comment section. And also if you think that this video will help any of your friends, then do share this video with them. And also if you want to watch more tutorials like this, then subscribe to my channel Learning Lad. And once again, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.